I'd like to talk to you today about how you can use can, could, and especially how you can use able to. There's quite a bit of confusion between these words for students, and that's very understandable because often they are interchangeable, but sometimes they're not interchangeable. So that's what we're going to have a look at today, how we can use can and could, or if we're going to use be able to. So first of all, obviously be able to is a more complicated structure, but the good news is we can use be able to for almost anything. So it's actually better to be using be able to rather than can or could for ability. So the structure is pretty easy. It's to plus be plus able plus to. That stays the same. The be is going to change to sometimes was or am or have been. Now let's consider how we might use this with a real situation. So playing the drums is probably a good example. So let's start with that. In terms of the present simple, we can say I can play the drums, or we can use able to. So I'm able to play the drums. Both are fine for the present simple. And in fact, we often prefer to use I can play the drums because it's easier to say. However, when we switch to the past, both again in the past simple are possible. So I could play the drums when I was a kid, or I was able to play the drums when I was a kid. So when we talk about something that we cannot do now, which we're not able to do, but we would like to be able to do, so again we can use both forms here. So you could say I would like to be able to play the drums, or I wish I could play the drums, or alternatively as well, you could say I wish I was able to play the drums. However, when we move to a more complicated tense, like the third conditional, for example, if I had practiced more, I would be able. This kind of tense, when it gets more complicated, you need to think, don't use could. We now want to switch to able to. So the third conditional, which we're using here, if I had practiced more, I would be able to play the piano. As a good example of now when we must use able to. So for the third conditional, we cannot use could. In terms of talking about the future in English with ability, we're going to use able to, and we're not going to use can. So for the future, we need to use I will be able to speak English more fluently after attending IELTS courses, for example. Just remember, you don't always need to use the word able to or can. We can just say, I need to speak English, or I hope to, or I want to. But today we're focusing on ability. So just to recap, we cannot use can for future events. For example, I can speak Russian after this course. Now that's a very common mistake that candidates make in IELTS. We also cannot use can for any perfect tenses, they're more complicated tenses. For example, we cannot say, I have could swim since I was a kid. So we're going to now need to change this. I have been able to swim since I was a kid. That's also true for all of the perfect tenses, so the past perfect or the future perfect. In terms of pronunciation, let's go and have a look at these things briefly now. The able to is more complicated because there's more words. So you want to link them together. And if we look at the first one up the top, I'm able to play the drums. So the able is going to become stronger than the to and the am. So the able is the strong sound. The future, I'll be able to speak English more fluently after attending IELTS Steve courses. So notice the first few words connecting together. I'll be able to speak. Now there are also some other word forms that use able, and it's very good to know these. This is more important for writing, to make your writing more academic. For example, doables, a good word. It's probably not so academic, but we could use it in our speaking or our writing. It's very commonly used at the moment, this word doable. So for example, learning to make your own website is doable now. Another word we use connected to able is disable. So you might have disabled people, for example, but also you can disable the button on your website. And yet another one is enable. YouTube enables anyone to upload their own videos. Another word that is very similar to able to is allow. It is similar, but not exactly the same. It's when we are given permission to be able to do something. For example, I was allowed to play football after school. Or school was a good one. We're allowed to bring our iPads to school. So a final question for you. What should you use then? Can, could, or able to? My advice, use able to as much as possible, unless you're talking about the past or the past simple or the present. Any other tense, just get used to using able to. Hope you found that helpful. Have a look at some more of my videos on IELTS Steve to find out anything more you'd like to know about using language and writing in the IELTS test.